Fly like a bird. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So today I'm gonna do a little non-car related video. It's still a garage related video because it's for some garage lights. These people over at Nathome, or I don't know how you pronounce it, Nathome I guess. They sent me these over to test. So if you guys didn't know my day job, I'm actually an electrical engineer. I do lighting designs, industrial building designs, and construction lighting type projects. So I'm pretty well versed in lighting as far as not just car lighting, but actual facility lighting and buildings. And I've been doing it for like 16 years now. So I've been doing it for, basically 15 or 16 years as my day job as an engineer. So they sent me these over to kind of test out. And what I'm gonna do today, I'm gonna install them in my garage. It's not like my garage doesn't really need light anyways. If you saw my video from a couple years ago where I installed, actually replaced some pretty good LED fixtures with some better LED fixtures at the time because one of these manufacturers, two of these manufacturers sent me samples, and it was actually, I was just upgrading the lumen pack, installed the same watts but more lumens out of it, and that's why the garage is always so bright. As far as doing car stuff, I got plenty of light, but your house probably doesn't have the luxury of that, so putting one of these screw-ins, the key to these is like they're screw-ins, so I'm gonna show you how easy it is to screw in. I'm gonna take the actual light level measurements to see what these things are performing at, and I'll actually put in a regular incandescent because these are designed to basically replace incandescent light bulbs. So I'll put in, not an incandescent, these days we're using LEDs, so I'll put in like a 9 watt LED that I have laying around, and we'll see how well that performs against this guy, because if you compare it to my garage now, it's not even a competition. I've got like over 100 foot candles right now in this place, so, but anyways, we'll get started on that test. So we'll go ahead and unbox one of these and see what the build quality and how well these are manufactured and if they're worth the money. I think they're only like $30-something on Amazon. I'll post a link to them on Amazon if you guys are interested in these exact ones. They were basically 80 watts. That's what they told me, about 80 watts, and they're rated at 8,000 lumens. So that's 100 lumens per watt, which coming out of an LED, just a screw-in LED, that's a pretty decent efficacy. These days in the industrial applications I'm designing, we're putting in 170 to 175 lumens per watt as far as the actual fixtures and luminaires go. Commercially available, they're over 200 lumens per watt. So this is about half the efficacy of industrial grade, very expensive LED fixture, well over $200, $250 for the fixture. The first thing I see is it's got a nice cap on it to cover the E26 screw-in. That's your standard US screw-in lamp, and I think it's used elsewhere too, but it's called an E26 screw-in. So the first thing I see is that you can adjust these to distribute the light wherever you need it. So if you have these lights in the middle of your garage and you want to distribute it out to the sides, in whatever direction you need the light, which a lot of cases in the garage you want it kind of outwards, this is a perfect, with the wings and everything on it, so that's pretty good there. So I kind of like that. In the box, really nothing else but these. The one thing I noticed is, you got all the little LEDs in here, so they've got all the little chips in on a board. So there's three boards, and then I assume the driver's in here somewhere. But overall, it's an aluminum cast wings, so that's good for heat dissipation. You got these little slits in them to help the air flow through and cool, so that's good for longevity. The lenses are, they've kind of got a little pattern in them to help diffuse the LED light to make it less glary. They actually have little holes in them, little venting holes to kind of let air flow, so that's good too to kind of keep the LEDs cool. So I'll go ahead and install it now. Actually, I'm gonna run the test first with a regular LED 9 watt bulb, and we'll measure the light levels as a comparison to these. Like I was saying earlier, my LED lighting setup in this garage is crazy. So I've got this one right here. It's probably a 170 watts, and that's probably a 215 watt fixture. And both of these are about 170 lumens per watt, I believe, at the time I was putting them up. Then I've got this other older strip, and I've actually got just regular T8 LED bulbs in there, just the direct replacement ones that use the standard T8 ballast, the fluorescent T8 ballast. So that's kind of my auxiliary light if I ever needed extra light. So I've got that on a separate switch, and I've got these on a main switch, and they actually have sensors on each of them. And that's because that's how I get them for industrial applications, which is good because my children leave the lights out here all the time. So they turn off after about 5 or 10 minutes of that. So I actually just put that regular light bulb. That's a regular screw-in 9-watt LED light bulb right now, right there. So I'm gonna turn off everything and I'm gonna measure the light levels and see what they're at. Oh man, this is dark as hell in here now. Look at this. But this is what most people's garages look like, I guess. So let me get the light meter out. So I've got the light meter set up here, and if we're reading in metric, which is in lux, we would be at 23.3 lux. So that's pretty bad, because that's like about 2.3 foot candles. So I'll change it to foot candles, and I'll get that. So in foot candles, I'm reading 3.4 foot candles. So that's the US measurement for lighting, so as far as light levels go. So that's 3.4 foot candles. That's freaking bad. So let's go ahead and put the screw in the other LED and see what happens. So earlier, what we were at, 3.4 foot candles, we're at 27.5 foot candles right now in the same exact spot I measured it before. Let's see the lux. So in lux, we're at 293.4 lux. So I'll bring the camera over just to show it. So yeah, look closer, there it is. So that's in lux right now, so if we hit the foot candles, 27 foot candles right there. So yeah, I mean, that is a 10 times the light that we're getting out here. But then again, we're also putting about 10 times the watts and 10 times the lumens, most likely, because that screw-in 9-watt incandescent, or no, 9-watt LED screw-in is probably like 900 lumens, 1,000 lumens. We're putting in 8,000 lumens, so yeah, somewhere around. It might be less than 1,000. It's probably 800 lumens, that screw-in. Those are the ones that you get at Home Depot for like $2 or $3. But anyway, yeah, you can just see, as far as the brightness goes in the rest of the garage, it's pretty acceptable, I guess, depending on what you're coming from. If you adjust those paddles, you'll get much better light on the outsides here. So let me go and adjust those paddles and see how we can distribute that light. So now that we adjusted it, we actually lost some of the direct light here, so we're down to about 24.3 foot candles, but that's because the light's actually distributed out to the walls now. So now we're actually lighting up the walls, we're lighting up the bench area and the work area over here, and we're lighting up that wall over there and back here. So it's actually giving us much better distribution of light around the actual garage and all the places that you might be doing work. You're actually getting better illumination now with this. You know, if your garage has two of these, if you put these two of these, that this would be pretty awesome for most garages compared to what you have now. Yeah, if you ever really wanted real garage lighting, that's the industrial stuff that I have there. As a quick comparison to what that bulb was getting out, this is all my lights on that I shown earlier, the two main ones and the auxiliary one. So I'm getting 116 foot candles, 116.1 foot candles in that same exact location versus the, what, like 24, 23 that we're getting out of that bulb. So yeah, that's a huge difference there as far as light output, but then I'm also running a lot more watts. So thanks for tuning in all the way to the end of this video, guys. It's a nice quick video on the review of these lights. You know, overall for $30-something on Amazon, it's a pretty good buy for what you get out of these. The construction's pretty good with the aluminum heat sinks, the way the wings flap and all that on these, and the ease of install with it being screwed in. These are also ETL listed for use in the US, which is good for the safety side of it, because that's one of the things you gotta be careful about with a lot of these China type electronics, is that if they're UL or ETL listed, that means that they've been inspected for safety and all that. So that's good that it's been ETL listed. So, you know, if I didn't have this awesome lighting in my house already from just because the kind of work I do, you know, I would hop on these on my own if I, you know, just buying them and upgrading my lights. So what I'm going to do is for you viewers that actually tuned in all the way to the end of this video, I'm going to actually give these away. So what I want you to do is just leave a comment down in this video. Tell me what kind of lights you run in your garage, what kind of setup you like, and what you do in your garage, and if you can use a upgraded light like this. So I'll choose two winners randomly once this video hits, let's say, 1,000 views, right? So I'll make it simple because not many people watch my videos on these little reviews. So let's say I hit 1,000 views. I'll select two winners. I'll announce the winner on one of my other car videos in the future once we hit 1,000 views on this video. And if you guys are subscribers to my channel and you watch them, you'll find out if you're the winner or not, and then let me know at that time in the comments on that video, and then I'll DM you, email you, or whatever, and we'll get the shipping address and I'll ship these out to you. So anyways, like the video, subscribe to your channel, and I'll talk to you guys next time.